Hey everybody, one more video today. A couple subscribers, when I was doing my Oak Island and Knights Templar videos, they asked me to look into the Statue of Liberty and if I had found anything, and actually I already had looked into it, and what I found was pretty interesting, so I just thought I would share, and I wanted to do something for my subscribers today, and I will explain why at the end of the video. But the Statue of Liberty, there's been a lot of crazy theories put out there about the symbology in the Statue of Liberty, but what does it represent? I think this is kind of widely known. I believe it is a representation of ISIS. This is the designer of the Statue of Liberty, Frederick Bartholdi, and he was a Freemason steeped in the mysteries of Egypt. And in fact, his original statue was intended for Egypt near the Suez Canal, and that got scrapped. So then he molded it into, or he took his ideas and molded it into the Statue of Liberty intended for the United States. It was completed by the same gentleman who completed the Eiffel Tower, also a Freemason. His last name was Eiffel, but I can't remember his first name. That's some pretty solid video prep there, Chuck, but anyway, I believe it is a representation of ISIS, the Statue of Liberty. The Freemasons were well-versed in the divine feminine, and I found a good article on that, and I will leave that link below. But I believe the Statue of Liberty, the designs were based on actually Juno, who was a representation of ISIS. She is married to Zeus, and this is her on a Vatican coin in 1963. And I believe the image of Juno was maybe the intended or the original design that Bartholdi took it from. But I just think that this Statue of Liberty is another thing in this country that has its origins in Egypt. The Washington Monument, of course, an obelisk, is another glaring example. But this is an overhead view looking down on the Statue of Liberty. And I kind of see a great pyramid here. Oh well, I just thought I would state what I thought. I wanted to do something for my subscribers today, and this is why. And on a personal note, I was looking at this a couple days ago, but today I will be going over 1 million lifetime channel views, and that is just staggering to me. I never intended to do this in the first place. I am nobody special. I think anybody can do this that has curiosity and imagination, and not just an understanding of knowledge, but a true love of knowledge. I guess I need to thank a special friend for encouraging me to do this in the first place, or I never would have. And the fact that what I've decided to share has been viewed over a million times now just blows me away. And I just like to say thanks for everybody for their comments and their shared interest in human origins and our ancient unknown past. So I just like to throw that in there. Hope you have a nice weekend. Take care.